Very good morning, students. Sairam, welcome back to your science period. So, children, you know now revision is going on, isn't it? For your unit test, you are having two lessons for your science B. So, that is classification of plants and energy flow in an ecosystem. Classification of plants revision was over. I hope you understood that lesson. Yes, shall I start now? Second one. Next one is energy flow in an ecosystem. Okay, so we will see one by one what is mean by ecosystem. So, children, an ecosystem is a community of living organisms in conjunction with the non-living components of their environment interacting as a system. So, ecosystem means that is living organisms in conjunction, the community of living organisms in conjunction with the non-living components, okay, so of their environment interacting as a system. So, ecosystem means that both are interconnected, living things and non-living components. Next one is, what are the factors related to the ecosystem? So there are two types of factor. First one is biotic factor and next one is abiotic factor. Bio means living things. So biotic factor, what will come? Living things will come. Can you give the example? Yes, plants and animals. Plants and animals. Okay, and next one is abiotic factor. That means absence of living things. That means non-living things. That means rocks, minerals, soil, etc. Okay, so these are the two factors related to the ecosystem. Can you say the name? Yes, biotic and abiotic factor. Now you know that example also, isn't it, children? Shall I go to next? So children, see here this slide. I have given one picture, that is meaning that biotic and abiotic factors are there here. Children, see, did you observe? Shall I go to next? Next one is four different trophic levels of an ecosystem. So in our ecosystem, there are four important trophic levels. That is, first one is primary consumers. Primary consumers, which is known as herbivores. Which is known as herbivores. Next one is secondary consumers. It is otherwise called as carnivores. Next one is apex or top consumers, which is known as carnivores. Fourth one is omnivores, that is, it is otherwise called as mixed consumers. Let's see one by one. Okay, what is meant by primary consumers? So primary consumers, that means herbivores, okay, which is known as herbivores. Primary consumers are heterotrophs. See here, children, primary consumers are heterotrophs. Heterotrophs means, you know very well, that is, it depends on other organisms for their food, that feed on producers. So these primary consumers will eat which one? Yes, producers. Then what is meant by producers? So in our environment, that producers, that means plants. All green plants will come under producers. Why we are saying that are the producers? Yes, plants are having the green color pigment, that is called what? Chlorophyll. With the help of the chlorophyll, in the presence of sunlight and carbon dioxide and water, these plants can produce their food by themselves. That's why these all plants, green plants, are called what? Producers. Okay, so these producers are eaten by primary consumers. It is otherwise called as herbivores. And secondary consumers feed on primary consumers. So these primary consumers are eaten by secondary consumers. Okay, and you know many example also, isn't it, children? Shall I go to next? Next one is, yes, secondary consumers, it is otherwise called as carnivores. These consumers use herbivores as their food. Okay, as I told that secondary consumers will take primary consumers. Primary consumers, which is otherwise called as herbivores. So, these consumers use herbivores as their food. Example, owl, fox, frog, etc. Okay, shall I go to next? Next one is apex are top consumers. Apex are top consumers. It is also otherwise called as carnivores. These consumers use herbivores and carnivores as their food. So these organisms, these consumers, these animals use herbivores and carnivores as their food. No other animal feed on top consumers. Okay, no other animals top. Yes, no other animals feed on top consumers. That's why it is called what? Apex or top consumers. Okay, example lion and tiger. So after the death of this animal, who will take? Yes, decomposers will absorb that remaining yes nutrients from these animals. Okay. So children, see here. Next one is omnivores are mixed consumers. So feed on herbivores. These animals, these organisms, feed on herbivores and carnivores. Herbivores and carnivores. That's why we are saying these are yes. These omnivores feed on herbivores and carnivores. That's why we are saying this is called what? Yes, these are called omnivores. For example, humans and bear, etc. Okay. Next one is yes, food chain. What is mean by food chain? So children, we discussed about the factors. Next one is four important trophic levels of an ecosystem. These all things we discussed. Now next one is food chain. Next one is food chain. What is mean by food chain? The interaction go on continuously between producers, see here, producers, consumers and saprophytes. Saprophytes means here decomposers, okay. And there is a definite sequence in these interactions which is called the food chain. So food chain means what? That continuously that interaction between producers, consumers and saprophytes. There is a definite sequence in these interactions which is called, it is a linear form. Okay, so it is called what? Chain, that is a food chain. See here, one example here I have given in this slide. This is first, yes, first is what? Producers. First is what? Producer, that means plants. And who will eat this plant? Yes, grasshopper. Okay, grasshopper will get energy from these producers. And this one is eaten by, this grasshopper is eaten by these mice. Afterwards, this mice is eaten by this, yes, snake. So afterwards, what will happen? This snake is eaten by this eagle. Afterwards, after the death of this eagle, yes, that soil, that microorganisms will decompose this dead body of this eagle. So that time, that remaining amount of nutrients or minerals, it is mixed in the soil. So from the soil, who is taking? Yes, again, this plant is taking that nutrients and minerals from the soil. Okay, that's why this is chain form. So we are saying that is, yes, that is your food chain. Okay, I hope you understood. So children, you have, by yourself, you have to prepare 2-3 food chain, okay, in your notebook. Next one is food web. What is mean by food web? So each food chain consists of 4, 5 or more links. Okay, an ecosystem consists of many food chains that are interconnected at various levels. So, and in one ecosystem, it contains many, that ecosystem consists of many food chains. Okay, so that are interconnected at various levels. Interconnected at various levels. Thus, so it is, if you are making that arrow, so it will look like a web network structure. So, that is what food web is formed. Okay. So children, see here, this is some 4, 5 food chains are here. Yes, this one is what? Producers. Okay, and this one, grasshopper is getting energy from these producers, and this grasshopper is eaten by, yes, this frog, and here this frog is eaten by this owl. So this owl, yes, this owl, and next one is, see here, another one food chain, yes, these plants. And here mice, and this mice is eaten by this fox. Okay, so here many food chains are interconnected, so we can say this is the, yes, food web. This is what? Food web. So children, see here, an organism may be the prey for many other organisms. For example, an insect feeds upon leaves of various plants, but the same insect is the prey for different animals like wall lizards, birds, etc. Okay, I hope you understood now what is meant by food chain and food web. Okay, shall I go to next? So, if this is to be shown in a figure, it will form an intricate web instead of a linear food chain. Okay, that's why such an intricate network is called a food web. Okay, so children, I hope you understood now. Shall I go to next? Next one is energy pyramid. Energy pyramid. What is mean by energy pyramid? An energy pyramid is a graphical representation showing the flow of energy at each trophic level in an ecosystem. So that each level of an ecosystem, that is called what? Trophic level. So that energy is transferred from one level to next level. So an energy pyramid is a graphical representation. So finally it looked like a pyramid like structure. That's why from one level to another level energy is transferring. Okay, that's why we are saying that is energy pyramid. So children, see here, this is one example here I have given. Here this is first one is what? Yes, producers. Producers will come at the base of that pyramid. Next one is who is taking energy from these producers? Yes, herbivores. From the herbivores, who is taking? Carnivores. From the carnivores, who is taking? Omnivores. Okay, so that energy is transferring. Yes, energy is transferring from one level to another level. Okay, so here herbivores, that is first trophic level of an ecosystem. So children, don't get confusion. Here herbivores, it is the first trophic level of an ecosystem. So what might be the second trophic level? Yes, second trophic level is carnivores. Third trophic level is an, yes, omnivores. Okay, I hope you understood now. Yes, so from one level to next level, which one is transferred? Yes, energy is transferred. Okay, shall I go to next? The energy pyramid, some important fact we are going to discuss now. Each level in the food chain is called a trophic level. Yes, already told. Yes, each level in the food chain is called what? A trophic level. The amount of matter and energy gradually decreases from producers at lowest level to top consumers at the highest level. So children, that each level of an of a food chain, that is called a trophic level. The amount of here, that energy is transferred from one level to another level. So that level of energy, that amount of energy is decreasing from one level to another level. Okay, so the amount of matter and energy gradually decreases from producers at lowest level to top consumers at the highest level. It shows the energy transfer that takes place at each trophic level. Okay, so the initial quantity of energy goes on decreasing at every level of energy exchange. So when that energy is transferring from one level to another level, that level of that amount of energy is decreasing. So similarly, the number of organisms also decreases. When comparing the producers, the number of herbivores, that is less. Okay, so similarly, the number of organisms and decreases from lowest level to the highest level. So next one is pyramid of energy. Next one is pyramid of energy. It shows the energy transfer that takes place at each trophic level. The initial quantity of energy goes on decreasing at every level. So suppose that initial level 100, yes, calorie of energy, so it is decreasing from one level to another level. Okay, so the initial quantity of energy goes on decreasing at every level of energy exchange. Similarly, the number of organisms also decreases from lowest level to the highest level. This pattern of energy exchange in an ecosystem is called a pyramid of energy. So that's why we are saying that is a energy pyramid. Okay, so finally it looked like a pyramid like structure. That's why it is called energy pyramid. I hope you understood, children, now. Yes. So children, now you know that energy is, yes, transferring from one level to another level. So finally, that apex consumers, it is having energy. Okay, so that energy, where it will go? In the process of obtaining food from the remaining of organisms, that decomposes, convert into simple carbon compounds. These substances easily mix with water, soil and air, from where they are again absorbed by plants. So from the apex consumers, after the death of that apex consumers, yes, that microorganisms, that means decomposes, will decompose that dead body of that animals. So that Yes, that organic, that nutrients are converted into a simple carbon compounds. So that simple carbon compounds are mixed with soil, water and air. So from the soil, water and air, this remaining amount of nutrients are absorbed by plants. Okay. So children, see here in this picture, here again one food chain I have shown here. So can you say which one is the main source of energy? Yes, this one is getting energy from this organism, and this grasshopper is getting energy from this producers, that means plants. But plants are getting energy from where? Yes, from sun. So sun is the main source of energy in an ecosystem. Okay. Green plants of the ecosystem store some of the solar energy in the form of food. Before reaching the decomposers, this energy is passed on from one trophic level to the next level. Okay. So decomposers dissipate some amount of energy in the form of heat. Decomposers waste some amount of energy in the form of heat. However, no part of the energy ever returns to the sun. So such passage of energy is referred to as one-way transport. Understood, children? So that energy we are saying that is one-way transport. Why we are saying? Because that no part of the energy ever returns to the sun. That's why such passage of energy is referred to as one-way transport. Understood, children? Yes. So children, this session, what we studied, what we revised? Yes, we revised about that ecosystem. What is meant by ecosystem? What are the factors related to an ecosystem? Next one is, yes, four trophic levels of an ecosystem: food chain, food web, and the next one is some example also we saw. And the next one is that energy, that one-way transport. Okay, one-way transport means what? And next one is energy pyramid. Why we are saying that is the energy pyramid? So these all things we studied, isn't it? So children, remaining part of that lesson we will see in next session. I hope you understood this one. Yes. Thank you, children. Saira.